Thanks for joining us for Ruth Institute's podcast. Our website is www.ruthinstitute.org. We seek to promote and strengthen traditional marriage. I encourage you to sign up for our free e-newsletter at the website, which has information on what we're doing around the country and how you can be involved. Chris Clark, senior pastor of East Clairemont Baptist Church, speaks on the relationship between government and the church at the Religious Liberty Rally in San Diego, California, part of a nationwide swell that included 140 rallies that day. Check out our podcast stream to hear the other speakers.
My Bible teaches us, and teaches me, that government gets its authority directly from God. My Bible also tells me that its focus and its purpose is to protect the liberties of its citizens, to reward good behavior and punish bad behavior. The problem is when a government does not know what is right and good behavior and what is wrong and bad behavior. And that, friends, is where the church comes in. I believe it was Dr. King that said it best when he said the church is neither the master of government nor the slave of government. The church instead is the conscience of government. Our detractors will look at a rally like this and say, there they go again. They're trying to impose a theocracy on us all. But that, friends, is foreign to anything that I read in the Bible. God does not force himself on anyone. What brings us here today are the results of a godless, secular moral code that's being imposed on us, that's being exemplified by this insurance mandate. It's not only being advocated, it is not just being forced upon the people of this nation, but now it is being forced and required upon religious institutions. And I today am standing before you to say, I have had enough. For far too long, pastors and religious leaders have remained silent on issues that even smacked or hinted of politics. And that has happened for the last 50 years, and I'm here to tell you I have had enough. I've had enough of government telling me that a baby in the womb is not a human being. I've had enough. I've had enough of government telling me that I need to radically redefine marriage for all of society. I've had enough. I've had enough of government telling me that I have to buy a product or else. I've had enough. I've had enough of government telling my faith-based institutions that I have to forcibly buy products that violate my religious convictions and the religious convictions of others. I've had enough. I'm not trying to impose my religious convictions on anyone, but I've had enough of government enforcing and imposing their convictions and their values on me. And if you share my feelings today, folks, I want to encourage you to pray this year like you've never prayed before for these upcoming elections. I want to encourage you to register to vote, and I want to encourage you to do something about it this November. Thank you very much.
You've just been listening to Pastor Chris Clark speaking on the church as the conscience of the government at the Religious Liberty Rally in San Diego. Check out our podcast stream for more of the speakers. Our website is www.ruthinstitute.org, and we're also on Facebook. Like the Ruth Institute or Dr. Jennifer Robeck Morse pages for updates. Our podcasts can be found online at ruthinstitute.libsyn.com and iTunes, and as always, they're under a Creative Commons license. If you've enjoyed them, please share them with friends. The Ruth Institute is a nonprofit educational organization devoted to bringing hope and encouragement for lifelong married love.